Hey everybody, welcome to the tape. This is a indie horror game that's on Steam. It's on sale for $3.59, but it was gifted to me. Thank you so much. So this game doesn't really have any info about it on the Steam page. It just says that it's a slow, creepy game with mythological something-somethings and a bunch of other shit. Mike, throw up the picture. So I thought I would check it out. It's only about like 40 minutes long, so I think this will be a full playthrough. I have no idea what to expect. I'm going into this 100% blind.
Yes. Yes, Mrs. Davis. I'm going there now. No, it's quite far from the town, and the road here in the forest isn't great, but I hope I'll be there soon. No, police searches all locations near. And I've got a few clues leading there. Bye.
Okay, so I'm assuming that I'm recording all this for, like, evidence? Because this looks fucking weird. There's no sprint. There is a jump, though. Interesting. This is made in Unity. So I already appreciate a few things. I'm not gonna shit on it right away. It kinda has like a The Ring kind of feel to it. The ambient sounds are suitably creepy. I like that they try to do something different with the visuals. That constant, like, static sound, though. Not a huge fan. Not that this is a bad thing, but these look like just store-bought assets. Which is, it's fine. That's what they're there for. If you use them correctly, then they aren't that bad. There's no door in this closet. Oh, is that the door? Overall, so far this is very weird. Like, I wonder how they did this to give it this like this effect. Daily Courier. Okay, so did a bunch of newspapers. I thought that like I could zoom. I feel like I should be able to zoom in. Cause it makes me like the visuals make me think I'm holding a camera, so I thought I could be able to like zoom in. But I guess not. Whatever. I have to say though, so far like I'm kinda creeped out. Okay, still can't read anything, so that's fine. I hate reading. It's for nerds. Fucking nerds. It's weird how the door opens towards us, like, and just, like, goes through us. This is a big, lovely white family. Ho 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 ho. Brud? That is a giant ass key.
I can walk through the table.
All right, so still gonna try to keep a open mind about things. It's only $3. The atmosphere and music are... hold me in there. Alright. Well, that sucks. So I'm investigating a murder. Interesting. The animation's actually pretty decent. Yeah, so far, like, I'm not hating it. It is very dark. Since there's no flashlight. Oh god. I'm in like a dungeon. So, yeah, since there's no flashlight, which, by the way, I appreciate. Thank you for not including a flashlight so far. Is that such like a Unity horror trope? It's just like, oh, give the player a flashlight immediately. Huh. Okay, so that's where she was killed. Where'd the bucket of bread go? Crouch? Nope. All right. I was gonna assume her position. Yeah, there's a horror game I played recently. It might have been Stairs, where like a few people actually commented on how like they wish indie developers would move away from giving their players flashlights immediately. Because, like, that, like, ever since, like, Slender the Arrival or something like that, or just Slender, I guess, that's been, like, such a, just, like, a trope of Unity. Okay, so, a lot of evidence that these guys are all Satanists. Satan. They all read the same book, apparently. That's why, like, the Satanic Bible or something. I've been looking around for notes and stuff like that to read, because I just in my mind that's something I have to do, especially when it comes to Unity games. But so far, this game isn't doing it, and I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. Hey guys. The visual styling is kind of making me, like, a little, like, headachey a little bit. That's fine. What? Let's try that again. That was super cute. Come here, buddy. Hey. That's fucking adorable. Alright, so their sight line is rather small, but they can also jump backwards. So I guess there's just like this round perimeter around them I have to look out for. So let's just keep our distance. Super cute. I love it. Yeah, and I like how light in the distance comes off as like the multicolored, like it's like a VHS tape. I guess that's why it's called the tape. Guess that's a hallway. Oh shit. Guess I'll stop in here for a second. I'm trying to listen to that sweet whispering. Nope. Alright. I asked for that one. I got impatient. So let's try going this way this time. And since there's no sprint, I can't just like barrel through it like I normally would. Like in a quadrant, whenever I just like started running through everything and it actually worked. Fuck that game. No, come on, man. Alright. I think I'm not being stealthy enough. But I think I got the plan now. Making sure that I wasn't within his attack range. So there's an open door back in this hallway. I'm gonna go hide in there, wait for the guy to walk by, then go through his hallway. I know what's up. I got this. By the way, I literally just woke up. This is what I do. I wake up, start recording. I'm playing a spoopy game. This is my life. Alright, good. Alright, so there's one right there. Turn. Okay, so he just patrols. I keep half expecting them to say stuff from like Resident Evil 4.
Go away, go away.
Alright, so I guess I'm back in the sacrificial chamber? Scripted? Yeah, okay. I'm making sure.
The animation is actually pretty good. Like, I'm kind of surprised.
Hey. What's up? What?
This is one of the weirdest games I've played in a while. Not like weird as in like bold boy weird. Just weird as in like what the fuck.
Oh yeah, and these are definitely all store-bought assets. But what they're doing with them is pretty awesome. Hey everybody, welcome to the ring. Cool. I think that's really cool. For a $3 game, this is actually doing quite a lot. It's not scaring me necessarily, but... So, I'm only 16 minutes in. It's supposed to be a 40-minute game. So yeah, it could do a little something something. So how you doing, everybody? You doing good? I'm doing good. Going to... That's fucking cool. That is cool. What's the bar? Bars. And now, of course, I'm getting text messages. Yeah, what are the bars? I don't want to touch any of them. Oh, there's that girl I was supposed to find. And is she the ring girl now? This is actually really cool. This is kind of cool. I like this. Yeah, so I'm going to Dallas today to hang out with my friend John. I'm assuming that's my health. The three bars. Hey. So I can't touch these guys, I'm assuming. I am... Nope, that's... something's on fire. Well, here's the bedroom I started out in. I'm really confused what the bars mean. Let's find out what happens if I touch these guys. Nothing. Okay. I'm assuming I need to stay away from her. I really don't know what to do. Well, sounds like she's to my left, so I'm gonna not go there. Really confused. Like, I kind of wish there was like an objectives thing. Please don't. Please don't push, buddy. Yeah, I wish there was like an objective. Like, find this room or something. There we go. Like right now the game's just kind of cryptic. She's to my left. And this looks like a fake door. And it's probably just a scene where the walls are meeting. This is a fake door. Okay, so maybe I need to find, maybe I found an item. I wasn't looking whenever that thing caught on fire. So So maybe I'm supposed to find an item that caused the other two squares to light up. Yep, there we go. Okay, got it. And then I go back to that room. Got it. And this leads back to the bedroom. Yep. So I wonder if she gets more aggressive as I find items. You're locked. Oh, you're open now. She's really close. My camera started freaking out. And it's locked. I could be totally fucked. Really confused. Okay. Bye. Peace out. Oh, so she's like right in front of me. So she just goes invisible sometimes. Ah, shit! Why? Was it on timer? Alright. I think it was on timer. Alright, let's try to the right. I don't think I went this way before. I did, it was a dead end. Haha. Okay. Get out of my ear. Buddy, what happened to you? Now that I know that I have to check the tables. Okay, well. Is the game like falling apart? Like, why are these guys floating now? Like, what's happening? All right, you're one. Boom. And this is the exit hallway, I believe. This is the last one. Boom. Is this the exit hallway? Nope. I just gotta find that middle one. All right, that takes me back to the bedroom. That was number one. So here, let's go this way and to the left. I'm glad touching those guys doesn't hurt. That would be really annoying. I have no idea where to go. Hey. Cute, love it. So I swear the picture should be one. Oh, because it is. Alright, so now on my screen I can see a marker. Alright, and I can know where it is. I wish I could sprint. Kill a man for some sprint. through here to the left. It's weird how they showed me the objective now. What? All right, awesome. This game has some really cool ideas. I'm digging it. The maze thing through the hall, that was a little eh, but I'm digging this. I have a countdown. Do I just need to make it to... the exit within a certain amount of time? I see you. Come here. Sweat? Like, an area like this needs a sprint. Alright, so I wonder what the deal is with this is. I wonder what the deal with this is. Words. Alright, it's gonna skip her completely. I wonder what happened if I just walk straight onto the darkness. She's right there. So that sucks. I'm just gonna ignore her. Fucking idiot. Dumbass. Oh, okay, now one of her hands came up and took some of the light. No! Stop it! Quit it! So I just have to survive for 3 minutes. Fucking dumbass. Ow, my head! Fuck! Alright, hopefully she didn't grab this one. Well, fuck you. Alright. Let's follow this moving one. Well, like, this looks cool. Now that I know what to do, it's not that bad. Gotta keep the ball in between me and her. Boom, dumbass. Fuck you. Alright, hand grab that one. I feel like they can't really grab the moving ones. Maybe they can. This one's gonna be easy. Boom, idiot. Oh fuck, I'm really far away. Oh no. I wish I had a sprint. I really, really, I know I keep saying that, but like, when a game takes my sprint away, I get salty. Alright, she's way out there. No problem. And I'll hang out with one of these guys. This one looks lower, so I'll drag her into this one. Boom! Dumbass. No, no. I want light. Quit it. I figure I need to stick with the low ones. So, okay, also the effects on the water look really cool. Boom, idiot. There we go. Yeah, like the red, yellow, white, blue effect that's on the water. Looks really cool. I like that a lot. What? Why am I at a grave? What? I kind of don't understand how all the set pieces are weaving together. Answers. Oh. I want answers, though. I want to know why, what's up. Alright, so I got a dude to my left, and I thought there was a dude to the right. They're so slow. You ain't gonna catch me, bro. Give up. Go put on some more white makeup. Try to look like Jeff the Killer some more. Yeah, let's get them answers. You wanted answers? You'll get them, Worm, but everything has its price. There is no girl now, there's only us. Born from pain and suffering, washed by blood, blessed by Lord of Darkness. We will swallow your soul and every other soul we meet on our way. Enjoy last minutes of your life, because soon all that you will ever feel will be eternal agony. Look behind you. This was the last thing detectives saw before his death. Police continued searching, but girl was never found. After some time, people started mysteriously disappearing in this area. Some people say there was a demon attacking people. Nobody can't say for sure what horrifying things could happen in the future. Okay, so it fell apart super hard at the end. Some really cool ideas. I like the visual styling, even though after a while it started giving me a little bit of a headache. But overall, I wouldn't say it was bad. It definitely fell apart at the end. The voice acting in the beginning, while not perfect, it was better than giving me a note with broken English. Because then that immediately took me out of it. And again, I'll say this, I'm not trying to pick on any game because they don't speak English fluently or as their first language. But when you're gonna put a product on sale on Steam, and if English isn't your first language, but that's what you are translating it to, you should run it by somebody that does speak English fluently. Because if you're trying to build a world in suspense, whenever I read a note that is nothing but broken English, it takes me out of it completely. And I spend more time trying to figure out what they're trying to say than actually realizing what they are saying. If that makes sense. Or does that make sense? If that makes sense. Yeah. I'm giving lectures about talking English and I can barely put words together. But yeah, I always say this and I'll say it again. Yeah, just, you know, get on Twitter, do a hashtag game dev, or go to Reddit
and post your script and say, hey, can somebody check this for me? Like, there's so many different ways for you to get your game out there and have it not fall apart like that. Like, honestly, like, I was enjoying myself up until that last segment. Yeah. That's my real complaint with the game. Overall, like, you know, it was 30s going on. It's probably gonna be like a 37-minute video. $4 is probably a bit steep for that amount of time. You know, that's $1 per 10 minutes. But this game does have nice ideas. It was interesting visuals. I like how it kind of tried to get the feeling of, like, The Ring. Execution-wise of the story, I don't understand what was happening at all. A bunch of Satanists, and then I was underwater, and then... yeah. That shit, like, I don't know what was happening. It was fun to play. It was fun to look at. But, like, story-wise, I don't see how it pieced together. Yeah, that's about it. So if you want to check it out yourself, link in the description. Thank you for watching. I will see you guys next time with whatever I decide to do. Bye.